So trust me when I say, mamas, if you out here doing it on your own, you that girl, and don't stress about staying in a situation or staying in a relationship with someone that is not paranoid to you. Channel, it's your favorite nurse babe Christen, and this video is strictly for, I want to say strictly for my single mothers, but that is who I feel like I can talk to, who I can relate to, who I was sent out here to help, because I was a single mom. I understand that plight. That's just me. But if you feel like this can, you can learn something from this, by all means, I'm sharing it for everybody. But I just had to get on here and have a message for my single moms that's going back to school. And I'm going to say this in the nicest way possible, because I went to LPN school with two kids, single, and I went to RN school with three kids. Now, all of my kids are not from the same person. I have multiple dads. This is not a secret. This has always been my story. I have never been ashamed of it. That's why my kids are 5, 7, 10 years apart. Because I honestly go into these situations thinking that I'm going to be in a long-term relationship with these men and get married. And it didn't work out that way. Because of whatever fuckery or whatever disloyalty or whatever, just stuff that I'm not about to deal with, made me single, because no baby never kept me. Like, a baby ain't gonna keep me. You're gonna have to be a lot more than just having a baby, because baby, I pack them babies up. I pack my babies up in a Sonata. Not once, but twice. I had the 2009 Sonata, packed up me and my two kids. Then I bossed up, got me a 2015 Sonata. And when that one got to acting up, I packed up me and my three kids in my Sonata, and we got the hell on. So trust me when I say, mamas, if you out here doing it on your own, you that girl. And don't stress about staying in a situation or staying in a relationship with someone that is not being loyal to you, not treating you as the woman you should be treated, not holding you up as the queen you should be treated, as the mother of their child or children, or not even marrying you. Do not waste your years on no man that's not marrying you. But that's not what I got on this video to say. It's kind of like the backstory. But I got on here to say, if you're single when you're starting nursing school, or during nursing school, or if for some reason you become single, or if he giving you too much. Like, because I know a lot of people who got divorced during nursing school. Stay single. Do not get with no man while you in nursing school. Trust me when I say, you need to finish nursing school and show yourself that this is something that you can do for you and your kids. You can do for yourself, so that you could be a better mom for your kids. Because he don't need to have no kind of opportunity and no inkling or no inch to be able to say that he made you, or you wouldn't be where you was at without him. So I'll never forget, I got back with one of my kids' fathers in April or May. Like, we got back together in April. He moved in May. And I graduated in July. So that's 3 months. Mind y'all, I went to school for 21 months. He kept my kids and the kid he has with me, but majority of them, all of them are mine. But anyways, he kept the kids while I took one test and maybe had to go to one clinical or one lab or something. It wasn't that much, but had the nerve to tell me that he helped me get my nursing license and I want to treat him like this. Nigga! I mean, like, man, sir, what the fuck is you talking about? And I hate to be cussing this early in the morning, but like, it was the audacity for me to have went 18, 19 months, through nursing school, lived at home with my mama, worked. Y'all know I already talk about it. I donated plasma. Like, he did not pay child support because we was in one of those on and off situations. So I never put him on child support. But, and yeah, I don't mind saying it. I mean, love will make you do crazy things. But anyways, or so-called love. But anyways, he wasn't shooting me no money, saying, I know you working hard. I'm proud of you. I support you. I stand by you. You know what a real nigga with money do. He wasn't even doing none of that. You want to know why? Because it was all cool when he was the one with the degree. When he was the one with the earning power. It was all cool then. How you going to raise these kids without me? Like, type of nigga. Like, it was all cool then. But the moment I really, like, buckle down, make the sacrifices, you know, by any means necessary, I'm going to succeed and pass and become the woman I want to be. Now, you want to help just a little bit, barely. Because at the end of the day, I could have probably took my kids over to my mama's house because me and my mama always lived next door or down the street from each other. At that time, we lived next door to each other. When you walk out my back door, you're at her back door. So, I could have sent my kids over to my mom's house. But you kept them because you're in my house. You're in our house, me and my kids' house. And you kept them, and you had the nerve to tell me that you helped watch my kids while I went off to school. And I got the nerve to treat you like this. This is why you don't need to give them the opportunity to say they did anything for you. And I'm not saying this coming from a place of hurt, because obviously y'all know I'm married and I'm not married to him. I am happy. And this is years ago, 4 or 5 years ago. So this is definitely old, and I have since healed from it. But I know what I know. And when I tell you, a lot of men, unless you got the right one, because if you got the right one, you ain't single. You ain't not here by yourself if you got the right one. But they will definitely come over and get jealous when they see you elevated and leveling up and becoming the woman you want to be, holding yourself to certain standards and holding them to certain standards. They gonna feel a type of way. And sometimes I feel like certain men be trying to hold women back because they see the greatness in you. So trust me when I say, I know it's hard. I know it's lonely. I know you wish you had that partner. And after nursing school, be weary too, because it's a lot of men that want to use you. Don't let nobody get on your coattail, sis. Like, for real, for real. I'm saying this with all of y'all. Know I get on here and I keep it 2 past 98 on here. Do not get with no man while you in nursing school. Y'all can be friends. Y'all can date. But you and your kids, this for you and your kids. This you and your kids' testimony. This you and your kids' journey. This you and your kids' success story. And when you do get with the next man, you the rich nigga. Like, I mean, y'all should definitely marry up. Get with a doctor, you know, a respiratory therapist, a nurse practitioner, whatever. But regardless, with or without a man, you and your kids will forever be straight. Because one thing about it, once you become a nurse, you'll never be broke again. Never broke again, Christen, is what I be saying. Because right now, I only work 3 days a week. If I really wanted to get on that paper chase, get on that money, hustle and bustle and grind, baby, I could work 5-6 days a week. Like, the opportunities are limitless. So I just want to give you just a good burst of motivation, and to give you it raw and uncut. Don't give no man no opportunity to say what he did for you and that he made you. He ain't make you. This journey is for you and God. You and your kids and God. Like, that's who this for. It's your dream. It's your passion. Yes. But this is you building the foundation for your legacy. This is you building the foundation for your kids' future. Do you know that once you alleviate the stress of thinking that gonna pay for bills and how I'm gonna take care of this and how I'm gonna take care of that. Once you alleviate that stress, that's just 80% of the battles, because we want to provide a good life for our kids. We want to provide lives that some of us never had, or maintain lives that we've had. So go ahead and just, you know, sneakily do whatever you want to do, but don't move, don't let no man keep you in no situation, because you ain't got to put up with it, one. And two, don't give him no opportunity to say he did this for you. And I'm not coming from no bitter black woman. I'm saying this again. I'm not a bitter black woman. I got a black man. Fine and all. And I still had more kids. I didn't give up on love. And I'm not telling you to give up on love. I'm just saying these 2 years, you got to buckle down. This ain't a year of love. Lock out. Get single. Stop going to the club. Stop hanging out all the time. Focus. Boss up. And then come back. And then pick the man that you want. And when you do get with a man, he already gonna know he gonna have to spend that cash, because you ain't taking nothing from no. All right, I love y'all. Leave a comment down in the comment section. Let me know if I'm right or if I'm wrong. Let me know, because I could be wrong. I'm not right about everything, but this is just a message that was put on my heart to share, and I know it's gonna resonate with somebody. Love you. Bye.